In Billboard tonight, a review of the latest film releases from Paul Lewis. I'll be talking to local crime writer Alfie Robins, and we'll have music from singer-songwriter Dan James. Good evening and welcome to Billboard with me, Ted Stanley, for a roundup of theatre, music, art and literature across the Humber region. Although the panto season is drawing to a close, you can still see Babes in the Wood, Radio Humberside's 18th annual charity pantomime in Cleethorpes, Hull and Bridlington from the 24th of January. Full details from the Radio Humberside Facebook page. A local amateur group are staging another charity pantomime, Snow White, penned by long-standing pantomime dame Neil Harking, at the North Cave Village Hall from Sunday the 21st of January. Our North Bank correspondent, Tony Barker, went to find out more.
Hello, Madge, how are you doing? How's things with
better?
You? Yeah, just get out of the way, you stupid, clown.
It's only taken me 6 years to get it written and start, you know, from start to finish, ideas and whatever. The last second act has been taking about probably 2 months compared to the other 4.5 years for the rest of it. But it's coming along great. I mean, the cast are doing a great job of it at the moment. There's a few tweaks that we've obviously had to do. It's the first time I've written anything. So we'll just see how it goes. But at the moment, it's good fun, it's a good laugh. The songs are good in it. They're all, you know, pulling their weight. So yeah, I'm looking forward to seeing it performed as I wrote it sort of thing, yeah.
Are you in it?
I'm in it well and truly, yes. I am the pantomime dame, would you?
No.
The production is in aid of a local man who needs a special wheelchair. Tickets are available from www.caveplayers.co.uk. Now, there's a real treat for lovers of Jane Austen as Austen the Musical comes to Beverley's East Riding Theatre from Thursday the 25th of January. The production explores Jane's struggle to have her work published in a male-dominated environment, her failed romances, and a woman's conventional lifestyle in Georgian England. Writer Rob Winlow tells us more.
It started way back in 2011, 2012, and started as a read-through at York's Joseph Rowntree Theatre with a few friends together, and we managed to get through it all with recorded backing music, and it's been developed from there. The more you look into it, the more you find out about Jane's suitors. She really was a very popular woman as far as the fellas were concerned.
Tickets for Austen the Musical are available from www.eastridingtheatre.co.uk. Now, although Austen was not a local girl, there's no shortage of aspiring successful writers in the region who enjoy competitions as a way of honing their craft and gaining recognition for their work. Julie Barker tells us about some local competitions you can enter.
The Creative Writing Festival, Tailspinners 2, is underway, where authors read out their work in front of a voting audience. All the details are available on otherlives.org.uk. If you're in North Lincolnshire, can you write a poem about life in your county? The theme is sense of place. There are gift vouchers for 3 age categories. The deadline is the 23rd of March, and the winning work will appear in an anthology. Visit northlinks.gov.uk. The 2018 Hammond House International Literary Prizes are now open for entries. The theme for 2018 is precious, and there are short story, poetry and screenplay categories. More information is at hammondhousepublishing.com.
Details of the writing competitions can also be found at www.billboardtv.uk. Now it's time for a review of the latest film releases chosen by film buff Paul Lewis. In film review tonight, we look at three billboards outside Ebbing, Missouri, Last a Flag Flying, and animated family film Early Man. But first, Scott Hooper's Hostiles. Set in New Mexico in 1892, this finely crafted Western doesn't flinch from portraying horrors inflicted during that violent period. Christian Bale stars as Army Captain Joe Blocker, tasked with escorting a dying Native American chief and his family to their home in Montana. It's a journey fraught with danger from outside threats and also from within the party itself.
The army wants to be certain that the chief gets home to Montana safely without incident.
I don't have any idea what he's got. He's a butcher.
And the two of you ought to get along just fine.
I've killed savages, because that's my job.
A combination of war picture, road movie and memory play, The Last Flag Flying, directed by Richard Lineker, is a comedy within a tragic framework, played out through the unstated emotions and idiosyncrasies of the characters that flow alongside and underneath the words. Three old army buddies come together to perform the somber task of burying a son killed in the Iraq War.
Ask the question, am I willing to surrender to God?
What the hell happened to Mueller the Mauler? First class drinker, gambler?
I see we have some visitors amongst us here today.
We were in the service together with your pastor.
I haven't seen these men in decades. They represent a dark period in my life.
That went down awfully quick.
Drinking for two now that you got old and boring. Shine down a
light on me. Three Billboards Outside Ebbing, Missouri sees a masterful performance by Frances McDormand in this hilarious comedy by award-winning director Martin McDonagh. A mother personally challenges the local authorities to solve her daughter's murder when they fail to catch the culprit.
I think I'll be all right then.
I guess you're Angela Hayes' mother.
That's right. I'm Angela Hayes' mother.
So, Mildred Hayes, why did you put up these billboards?
My daughter Angela was murdered 7 months ago. It seems to me the police department is too busy torturing black folks to solve actual crime.
The hell is this?
Dixon, I'm in the middle of my goddamn Easter dinner. Sorry, kids.
I know, Chief, but I think we got kind of a problem. Sunshine
beating on a good time. I'd do anything to catch your daughter's killer.
I don't think those billboards is very fair.
Set at the dawn of time, Early Man tells the story of courageous caveman Doug, played by Eddie Redmayne, and his best friend Hobnob, as they unite his tribe to save their home against a mighty enemy, Lord Nuth, played by Tom Hiddleston, and his Bronze Age city.
Right, grab a spear.
Oh, it's pointy.
Change your underpants today?
Yeah, changed them with dongle.
Never mind.
On DVD and Blu-ray, Arrow Video's Cat of Nine Tails is also worth a look. The early influences of local singer-songwriter Dan James included Coldplay and the Beatles, but now his music resonates with the contemporary sound of artists like James May and Passenger. I caught up with him earlier in the Performing Arts Centre at Grimsby Institute. So, Dan, thanks very much for coming on Billboard. Nice to meet you. So, when you first started, who were your musical influences? Who did you aspire to be like?
At the start, I was very keen on Oasis. Oasis, Beatles.
And what about contemporary musicians? Is there anyone who's around at the moment that you...
There's Benjamin Francis Lefwich. He's right. Been around for years. There's Tom, there's Watson. Then, yeah, I'm very keen on...
I mean, listening to your music, it reminds me quite a bit of bands like Passenger, for instance.
Yeah.
Do you
very keen on Passenger. Yeah. That's where I learned my finger picking, how to finger pick.
Now, I understand you're writing some more songs at the moment that you're planning to record during the course of this year.
Well, I've just been in the recording studio and we're releasing more music throughout the year.
And, I mean, as well as recording music, you also play live gigs as well. In fact, you played at the Hammond House International Literary Festival last month. Was that a good gig?
Oh, I enjoyed that, yeah. It was a nice little crowd there.
So we're going to be hearing some of your music later in the programme, but in the meantime, thanks for joining us, Dan, and good luck with the musical career.
Thank you.
After the break, I'll be talking to Hull-based crime writer Alfie Robins, and Melissa Shaw will tell us about the latest shows in box office. But now, the very talented Dan James with one of his earlier releases, Autumn Breeze. Back to Billboard. Still to come on tonight's show, a new exhibition celebrating the magic of the Humber, family fun at the Ferrins Gallery, and I'll be finding out if a successful local writer is giving Hull a bad name. But first, we look at how the work of Yorkshire's most popular and prolific playwright, Alan Ayckbourn, is celebrated at the Brough Village Hall, as the Pituri players stage Roles Apart. Ayckbourn's propensity for farce is displayed in this chaotic clash of cultures and families, as director Jane Houston explains.
Oh, hi, Dee.
Hello, Justin. Dee Jobson, pleased to meet you.
Pleased to meet you.
I'm Derek's wife.
Julianne and Justin are doing their first dinner party to announce their engagement, and you find out that she's so, like, very high maintenance. And then her parents turn up. But before her parents turn up, he has an occurrence where somebody drops him, sort of like a neighbour from upstairs, and she's on the run.
Roles Apart runs from three nights from Thursday the 25th of January. Tickets are available from www.pituriplayers.com. The magic of the Humber has been captured in a new exhibition at the Beverley Art Gallery. The Humber Estuary, Changing Views, includes artefacts from sources across the north, specially commissioned artwork, and superb drone footage. Museum manager Niall Adams tells us more.
The curators involved began to break it down into the usual headings: natural history, archaeology, maritime history, etc. But to a certain extent, we were dictated by the material which we managed to assemble. And I have to thank here the numerous art galleries and museums which contributed.
The Humber Estuary Changing Views exhibition is free and runs until the 17th of February. Time Troopers is another free, family-friendly event that takes place across Humber Museums on the second Saturday of every month. The next event, on the 10th of February, is hosted by the Ferrins Gallery, where the whole family can enjoy fun craft activities inspired by the collections. Details from www.humbermuseums.com. I was joined earlier by local crime writer Alfie Robins to find out if he is doing for Hull what Ian Rankin did for Edinburgh. So Alfie, thank you for joining us on Billboard.
Thank you for inviting me.
When did you start writing?
I think it was probably about 8 years ago, following a work accident, that I actually started. Yeah. I've always been a big reader.
Yeah.
And then I'm sat at home with my shoulder, all bandaged up, and one of my daughters says to me, "You ought to have got writing a book instead of sat there reading." That's how it all came about.
And when you started writing, did you have any particular influences, any other authors who...
Peter Robinson. Peter Robinson. I think he's been a big influence with him, been writing all about Yorkshire, etc. And I do like Peter James.
Peter James.
And Rankin with his Edinburgh. Yeah.
And your stories are all set in
Hull.
In Hull.
Yeah,
right.
Hull and the sort of villages around the area.
Around the area. So a bit like Ian Rankin's books are all set in Edinburgh.
Yeah.
Now, Ian's been accused of giving Edinburgh a bad name with his crime books. Do you think you're doing the same?
Yes, I think I have, with one or two of the reviews where people don't recognise things and Paul's not as bad as he's writing about, etc. A lot of people just don't realise the fiction.
Yeah. Yeah. Indeed, yeah. So, I mean, now you're a successful writer, eight published books, and you know, probably the most well-known crime writer in the local area. What advice would you give to new writers and new authors who want to write a novel and get published?
Well, if you want to write one, just take a notice of anybody who says you can't write one.
So when can we look forward to another book from you?
Well, the next book, I'm hoping April, May time, something around about there. And it'll be a new DCI Marlowe one.
Ah, okay. Yeah. Right. But in the meantime, people can buy this?
Yes, all the books are available from Amazon, of course, as a Kindle or a paperback, yeah. And to order from any good bookshops as well.
Great, lovely. Yeah. Well, Alfie, thank you for joining us on the programme. Good luck with your new book.
Thank you very much for inviting me.
Nice to see you again.
Thanks very much.
Prolific and successful crime writer Alfie Robins. Now, here's Sarah Hunter Carson with her own choice of January book releases.
Some great books have been released in January. Here are some you might like. Midwinter Break by Bernard McLaverty is a subtle, moving story of love and of a long relationship in the course of which two people have fallen out of step with each other. A brilliant study of monogamy, this masterful novel explores the slow damage of compromise within a marriage. The two central characters, haunted by the troubles in Ireland, try to close the door on the past, whilst in the present, the decision to take a long weekend in Amsterdam proves a catalyst for self-examination. Why We Sleep by Matthew Walker explains why so many of us struggle to get a good night's sleep these days. This book, written by a neuroscientist, has probably never been so relevant. He discusses in detail all the whys of sleep and the science behind it, exploring the link between sleep and health. Fascinating, both analytical and contemplative, this book will interest both scientists and general readers. The Tobacconist by Robert Zeitaler is set in 1937, and the shadows are lengthening across Europe. Set in Vienna, this lovely novel follows a young man who works in a small tobacconist as an apprentice and strikes up a friendship with Sigmund Freud. As the world darkens, the lives of all will be irrevocably changed. Charming, yet full of yearning and melancholy, this book is a beautiful elegy for a vanished world. Now, for lovers of a good legal thriller, here's the latest from John Grisham, The Rooster Bar. Grisham's experience as a lawyer means that his writing about the law is accurate and realistic, and here he explores the very real problem of the exploitation of law students within the context of an engaging plot. The Hammond House anthologies of short stories and poetry include award-winning writers from around the world, each with their own unique take on the theme eternal. Both are available from www.hammondhousepublishing.com.
Now for a roundup of what's on where you are in box office with Melissa Shaw.
At the Baths Hall Scunthorpe, you can see a spectacular concert featuring the life and music of David Bowie on Friday the 2nd of February. And there is a unique opportunity to see the St. Petersburg Classic Ballet perform Swan Lake on the 14th and 15th of February. Grimsby Auditorium takes you on a musical journey through Neil Diamond's glittering career on Friday the 2nd of February. The exciting Cirque Enchantment perform on Friday the 9th of February, and you can enjoy a tribute to the music of the Supersonic 70s on Saturday the 10th of February. At the Riverhead Theatre in Louth, you can enjoy famous fairy tales by the Brothers Grimm as told by students of the King Edward VIII Grammar School for three nights from Wednesday the 31st of January. Also at the Riverhead Theatre, the Elite Academy of Dance perform from Thursday the 8th of February. The Culture, a farce in two acts by James Graham, exploring and exploiting the inner workings of Hull 2017, is at the Hull Truck Theatre until Saturday, the 17th of February. The popular Back to Ours Festival returns to a variety of venues around Hull from the 14th of February. Full details from www.hull2017.co.uk.
That's almost all for tonight's show. Next time on Billboard, we go behind the scenes at a local theatre, find out the benefits of joining a film club, and meet a local children's author. Details of the events featured in tonight's programme can be found at www.billboardtv.uk. If you would like us to feature your own arts and entertainment event on Billboard, you can email details to ted@estuarytv.com. Thank you for joining us. From everybody on the Billboard team, a very happy new year, and we look forward to seeing you again in February. Here with the conclusion of Autumn Breeze, the very talented Dan James.